What it do, man? It's your boy LP, aka LPZ. And just want to do this car pistol. Just want to talk about some current current events that's taking place right now. A lot of people speaking on it, dealing with it, and I've said my piece. I've shared, you know, certain posts and stuff like that. But I just want to share this right quick. As far as the body of Christ, now, you know what I'm saying? If you're not a born-again believer, if you're not in the church and stuff like that, this is not for you. So you can go ahead and just stop the video. For the believer, with the response, you know, I'm always about, you know, dealing with our response towards certain things. A lot of times we don't respond, we're reacting. And a lot of the reactions of the people as a result of the unjust treatment of individuals, you know, they react in a certain way and they want to do certain things. I want to encourage the body of Christ to respond in the way that the church should respond. Over in Acts chapter 7, there was a man named Stephen. He was a good man, didn't bother nobody. All he did was preach the gospel. And he preached the gospel, and, you know, as a result, you know, he kind of changed the tone and said some things or whatever. The people got upset, and they took him, and they stoned him and killed him. And the Bible talks about over in the next chapter, chapter 8, it says that Saul consented. You know, Saul was like, yeah, kill this dude, you know what I'm saying, take him out or whatever. And after Saul began to do what he did, you know, the Bible talks about how the church, the body of Christ, the believers, the followers of Christ, immediately, they didn't mob up together and protest and march and things of that nature. They didn't do that. The Bible says they begin to spread out and preach the word. They begin to spread out and preach the word. The word began to be spread out and preached. Not only was it preached, the gospel of the kingdom of God was preached, and the lame was healed and the sick were healed, and all the great miracles took place. And the Bible says that there was great joy in the city. Now, if we follow behind what the world is doing, all we're going to do is create more turmoil and chaos. And whenever you do that, you're falling into the hands of something called New World Order, because when chaos takes place, it's chaos that they created, and they're going to bring order out of chaos. Now, that may be a little deep for some people. I don't really want to go into that, but saying all that to say, I want to encourage the body of Christ to do as the church in the book of Acts did. Whenever they was under the oppression of unjust treatment, and somebody was killed unjustly, they begin to spread the word of God. They begin to function according to the word of God. And the Bible says there was great joy in the city. I don't know about y'all, but I'm tired of the darkness and the hatred and the killing and all the stuff that's taking place in this city. I don't know about you in your city, but I'm tired of seeing it. So I want to encourage the church to start preaching the word, to start operating in the gifts, to see people healed, see people delivered, see people set free, so that they can be great joy in the city. Holla at your boy, man. It's either you're going to do the word or you're not. Holla at your boy.